Good, you're back. Do you have a moment? I struggle to admit this. I must abandon my efforts at opening a rift to reach Alcor. For all I've learned in battling the occult, I'm no warrior. During my last attempt, I nearly lost control of the ritual when something tried to breach my portal from the other side. This is too dangerous to continue. To make matters worse, Captain Bourbon has just arrived with a girl named Amala, bearing dire news from the east. While we struggled here to stop the Chthonians from unleashing terror and madness upon the world, the Ethereals have been far from idle. Everything they had done in this region is merely a sample of what is to come, if what Amala says is true. As much as it pains me to say this, our plans to rescue Algrim are secondary to this rising threat in the fallen city of Malmuth. The passage north from Berwich is quickly closing as the Aether Fire consumes everything. But perhaps we can accomplish both goals at once. You see, the Luminari have long been aware of a coven of witches hiding out to the north of Berwich, using the treacherous territory to deter pursuers. The witches will know the lay of the land and should be aware of any paths that remain through the Aether Fire. And I have hopes that they will be able to do what I could not, reveal where the Lochorian has taken Algrim. I would go myself, but I doubt the arrival of a high-ranking Inquisitor will be looked upon kindly within their circle, and I am needed in Devil's Crossing. I know that you have suffered much already in the defense of humanity, but you are the only one entrusted with this. Take my pendant and travel north from the Berwich Estates. The barrier of Aether Fire will stand in your way, but the pendant will make short work of it. Head north through Gloomwald until you've reached the edges of Ugdenbog, where I believe the Coven has made their home. You cannot arrive empty-handed, or they may well burn any memory of discovering their location right out of your mind. I recommend you hunt down a creature known as Caraxes Foul, the Scourge of Ugdenbog. I imagine it has grown quite large over the preying on unwary travelers making their way through Gloomwald. Find the beast within its waterside lair, Gloomwald, and bring its heart to the Coven. I'm sure they'll find some nefarious use for it. But we must overlook that in light of our situation. Show them this keepsake of Algrim's and find us a way to Malmuth. We will be awaiting your signal.
I overheard that you will be headed beyond Gloomwald in the hopes of reaching Malmuth. It's noble of you to spearhead this effort, but I was hoping there was something you could look into for me. You see, I did not travel down here alone. I was with my father. He was injured in Gloomwald, and I had no choice but to leave him behind in search of aid.
My father and I were part of a small group that managed to escape the confines of Malmuth's ruins. We did not get far before the casualties began. The spreading Aether Fire and roaming Ethereals saw to that. But it was not until we reached Ugdenbog that the horrors truly began. Cannibals, poisonous fumes, and even carnivorous plants threatened our every move. By the time we entered Gloomwald, it was just my father and I, but we were not out of danger yet. A pack of cannibals ambushed us in the night. My father was injured in the fray. While it wasn't fatal, I had no choice but to leave him so that I could find help. Eventually, I found my way to Devil's Crossing. I'm not sure how long my father can survive on his own. He was never very good with weapons, or much of anything, for that matter. Nevertheless, he's the only family I've got left, and I want to look for him. But the Inquisitor insists that I first debrief him on every detail that I can recall on Malmuth. On your way through Gloomwald, will you spare some time and search for my father? He cannot have strayed far from the main road.
Setting out for...
Got something you need stashed?
I'll keep an eye on this. come here.
Please, just leave me alone out here.
Thank you.
Got something you need stashed? It's safe with me. Promise. It's safe with me. Promise.
Come here. power.
Oh!
See anything you like? Put it to good use. See anything you like? See you around.
Whatever it is you think you're doing here, you are in the wrong place. Interesting. It appears that perhaps we can be of use to each other after all. Very well. Speak. What brings you to our refuge? If you seek a path to Malmuth through the swamps, then I am afraid you are out of luck. The roads have all but collapsed. And even if you should somehow find your way out of the bog, the land beyond has been consumed by aether fire. Ancient passageways exist that could take you north, but they are not of this realm, and you will not like where they lead. Now, this friend of yours? What happened? Ulgrim, you say? Oh, it would be a shame to lose such a legend. But if he was claimed by the Void, then... Perhaps this gives me an idea that will solve both your predicaments. But if we are to help with this, then I must ask for something more in return. What you ask will take me some time to prepare. But before I help you, there is something you must do for us. Deep within Ugdungbog, to the north of our refuge, there lies a village by the name of Barrowholm. I need you to travel there. I care not for the village, only for what was stolen. We had crafted an Ugdumbog fetish within the swamp in order to protect ourselves from the wilderness. Recently, someone has tampered with it, tore off the head of the fetish, and ran off with it. I can still sense its waning power within the bog, and the only nearby settlement is Barrowholm. I do not care what you do. We must have it returned to us. Do this, and I shall give you the means to find Ulgrim, and perhaps even a way to Malmuth.